Good morning.
Basketball fans, Dorothy's son.
son-in-law is the president of Duke University, and so, but it hasn't got me any tickets yet. Maybe. Anyway, shortly after the service, we will be going into the Arnold Hall where there will be a luncheon, and all are invited to partake of the luncheon. However, it will start with the newest inductees of the 50-year membership club, along with their families. Someone gave me a $50 bill to bribe me into letting the families go to. No, I'm just kidding. The family will get to go as well, so family and new members of the 50-year club, and then the rest will be complete chaos. I will be saying the prayer here, though, so we will rise and go out there. So go out as many as you can to eat and partake of this wonderful luncheon. Sadly, I have to leave a little bit earlier than normal today, so if you have pressing business with me, call me on Monday. My family is commemorating the Memorial Golf Tournament in memory of my brother-in-law who passed away, and so I'll be attending that briefly after the service. I would like to just make one other acknowledgement while I am thinking of it, and that would be Alex Dumas. You may have seen him. There he is. You may have seen Alex Dumas on television the other day. Coming home, he surprised his brother, and his brother was very enthusiastic to see him. Tears dripping down his eyes. Or actually, his brother went like this. So, probably one of the most emotional homecomings I've ever seen. It's going to be on, I'm sure that it will be on America's Funniest Home Videos someday, too. But congratulations for being back, Alex, and all that you do. For those who don't know, Alex served our country by helping with the rescue and actually recovery efforts of the Malaysian flight that crashed into, what was it?
AirAsia,
I'm sorry. Yeah, AirAsia, the flight that crashed near the Philippines or somewhere down there. And so he helped with that, so you can certainly appreciate his hard work and all of that. Okay, so without further ado, let us begin our worship.
Please rise and join me in the call to worship. Who is our sovereign and Savior?
The Lord.
So after I do, you can sit, I'll do the piece that for the choir will listen to me. So that's not going to go to the should know. Let us continue our worship of God with our opening prayer. Please stand.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Gracious God, send us your Spirit to guide us into the truth, so that we may know and trust the good news of the gospel, and look with hope and joy for the life of the world to come. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you.
going to have a little walk back in time. It starts in the 1930s at First Presbyterian Church. Imagine, if you will, in the 1930s, the pastor was the Reverend Dr. Palmer, known as a strict fire and brimstone preacher, much like me, I think. No. I doubt that Reverend Palmer would have been called Jim in public sphere. But here it is, 1930s, First Presbyterian Church. Keep the lights dim because I'm going to be moving through time now. That was 1930s. You can see all the wonderful hats. That was when Dorothy Degnan joined the church, and at that time, Reverend Palmer was the pastor. But time goes on, as we all know, and it will seem like only tomorrow that Katie Miner, who joined the church last week and read today, will be celebrating her 50-year membership. But moving on to 1965, the year of our Lord, 1965, when our newest members joined. 1965 was a very, very busy year with much going on. In January 20th, 1965, for the first full term as an elected president, Lyndon B. Johnson took the stage at the inauguration to declare the Great Society. Let's look back in January of 1965 and see if we can, see if I can find my cursor. There it is. 1965, January.
Thank you. understanding.
Reference in that piece was the Vietnam War. Prior to 1965, there were, much like what is taking place in Syria and Iraq, the Air Force and the Army Air, the Navy Air Force, the Navy Airmen were dropping bombs out of North Vietnam. The first Marines entered Vietnam in 1965. And also entered the Dominican Republic to fight there as well. This is a newsreel from 1965.
That's all we'd like to sing. It's our latest record. Thank you.